Hi, I'm Bob French. There's a lot of bad information floating around out there about investing. And for me, one of the most frustrating misunderstandings is something called income investing. This is the idea that you should focus on the amount of income that your portfolio is generating through dividends from stocks or interest paid out of bonds or some other distributions being kicked out of other types of investments. Now, I get the appeal. Especially if you're in retirement and living off of your portfolio, you don't need to touch your principal, so it's safe. The thing is, though, we aren't Edwardian lords living off land rents like in Downton Abbey. It just doesn't work like that. First off, it's important to understand that income investing is economically equivalent to normal or total return investing, where you just treat your whole portfolio as a big pool of money, which it is, since money is fungible, which is also why income and total return investing end up in the same place. The easiest way to show this is with an example. So let's do that. Say we're looking at two companies, ABC and XYZ. And just to make our lives easier, we'll say that we own 100 shares of each. And they're both trading for $20 per share. That means that we have $2,000 invested in each company. But now, let's say that XYZ decides to issue a $1 per share dividend. This means that they're going to send out a dollar per share, so their stock price will drop by that same dollar. And now we've got $100 in cash. So if we focus on just the portion of the portfolio that was invested in XYZ, we've still got our 100 shares, which are now worth $1,900, as well as the $100 in cash. We still have our $2,000. We've just moved it from one pocket to the other. No money was created or destroyed. But we can do the same thing without having to wait for the company to decide to pay a dividend. We can make our own. In this case, let's focus on ABC. We still want our $100 in cash. But instead of getting that money in the form of a dividend, we can raise the money by selling 5 shares. So now we have 95 shares of ABC, which is still trading at $20 since they didn't send out any money, which means that we still have $1,900 in ABC, as well as the $100 in cash from selling the shares. Just like with XYZ, we've still got our original $2,000. Again, we're just moving money from one pocket to the other. And it's worth pointing out that the broader idea of this, that capital structure is irrelevant, absent the effect of taxes and a couple other things, which we'll touch on in a second, was one of the key insights that got Franco Modigliani his Nobel Prize. But it's worth calling out that wrinkle I just mentioned. Taxes. If we're doing this in a taxable account, you're likely to have to pay more in taxes for the money you generated from dividends compared to the money that you raised by selling shares. So it's entirely possible that income investing will actually leave you in a worse position than you would have been in with total return investing. However, to get to the point where you're focusing on the money being kicked out of the portfolio, you need a portfolio to begin with. And this is actually another massive problem, because to generate the amount of distributions that folks looking to use income investing are looking for, it means that you'll likely need to focus your portfolio on the types of investments that, well, send out those big distributions. And these types of investments don't really look like the broader market. On the stock side of the world, not all companies actually distribute dividends. And think about the type of companies that will be sending out big dividends. They're generally going to be the companies that don't think that they have a better use for the money internally. They don't have any projects poised to revolutionize their markets or even just make them a lot of money. So they pass the money back to the owners, who presumably have better uses for the money. In other words, these tend to be value companies. And tilting your portfolio towards value companies is perfectly reasonable. But the problem is that you'll be capturing the value premium in a distorted way. If you want exposure in your portfolio to the value premium, and again, that's perfectly reasonable to do, depending on your risk preferences, then there are just much more effective ways of getting at it without the distortion of focusing on dividend yields. On the bond side, increased interest payments simply mean taking on more risk, either through buying longer maturity bonds or just lower quality bonds. I'll look at this in other videos, but by and large, you don't get paid as much for taking risk with bonds as you do with stocks. So you want to minimize the amount of risk that you take with your bonds. You want to spend your risk budget on the most efficient things possible. But all of these so far have been technical reasons that income investing just doesn't make much sense. There's also a pretty big planning reason not to go down this road. Essentially, what you're doing, especially if you use dividend payments as a big source of income, is giving up control of your retirement spending levels. On the bond side, if you're using bond funds, you just get whatever the market is currently kicking out. Or if you're using individual bonds, whatever the market was kicking out when you bought the bonds. So in the words of my first grader, you get what you get and you don't get upset. On the stock side though, you're outsourcing your spending decisions to the boards of directors of the various companies that you're invested in. Now, their job may technically be to represent the interest of shareholders, but they don't really care about your retirement. And it's also worth pointing out that dividend policies change through time. As we're seeing now in the age of Corona, a lot of companies, even ones thought of as pretty stable dividend payers, are pulling back or just eliminating dividends to hold on to cash to deal with the current uncertainty. To put it mildly, this is not when you want to worry about a significant drop in your income. What you want to be doing instead is using what's called a total return approach, essentially treating your portfolio as one big thing, which it is. There's no differentiating between principal and income. It's all just your money. If you think of your portfolio like a well, when you drop your bucket in to get some water, you don't worry about which part of the well the water came from. It's all pretty much the same. Just like with your portfolio. You want to build your portfolio to be as effective and efficient as possible to help you reach the retirement that you want. And focusing on the amount of income that an investment happens to send out just does not do that. If this was helpful, be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel so you can see what we're up to. If you have any questions on this or any other questions that you'd like me to address, just drop them in the comments below. You can also check us out on the web at retirementresearcher.com and make sure to sign up for our weekly newsletter to keep up to date with everything that we're doing.